Jewish people opposed the occupation of Palestine from the very beginning. It was in the 1930s, before the creation of the State of Israel, when the politics began, when the Zionists came into the region. Rabbi Sonnenfeld, at the time, wrote an article in one of the Arabic newspapers. It was called Peace and Truth, in which he wrote, he was the chief rabbi of Palestine, clarifying that the Jewish people have no demand over any place holy and sacred by the Muslims.
Yes.
In 1947, a year before the creation of the State of Israel, Rabbi Dushinsky, the chief rabbi of Palestine at that time, wrote a written testimony to the United Nations meeting in Jerusalem. And I quote, "We furthermore wish to express our definite opposition to any Jewish state, to a Jewish state in any part of Palestine." He was ignored by the United Nations at the time. Several months later, Rabbi Dushinsky sent a telegram to the United Nations in Lake Success that at least leave Jerusalem free.
Yes. 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 Yes.
And that request was respected. This was how Jerusalem was kept for decades. Jewish leaders, the Jewish communities worldwide, opposed the creation of the state and still do. The philosophy of Zionism is not only causing a catastrophe for the Palestinian people, it is a true disaster for the Jewish people as well. What it has done to our people, it attempts to transform Judaism from a religion into a nationalism, uprooting all sacred holiness of our religion. Shame! The concept of creating a sovereign homeland for Jews happens to be totally forbidden according to Judaism, since according to our belief we are in exile and we are forbidden to end exile by any physical means. But on top of all these crimes against the Palestinian people, all this bloodshed, expulsion of its people, and oppression of those people still remaining is totally criminal, not just in international law,
yes,
but in Jewish law itself. We are standing here after hearing these news regarding Jerusalem. We plead with the President of the United States of America, please rethink this policy, because this is not only escalating violence, this is continuing this terrible occupation, which is not in favor of anyone involved in the conflict.
Yes.
We are witnessing bloodshed, rivers of bloodshed, from all sides of the conflict. Why? Just for this political movement that is criminal and anti-religious, anti-Jewish. We pray that beautiful peace that did take place in Palestine prior to this political conflict, that beautiful peace should be an example for us all. And we pray to Almighty God to spare us all and to have that peace once again in the Holy Land, in Palestine, and in Jerusalem. Ultimately, we pray for the glory of the Almighty be revealed throughout the universe. All mankind together will serve the one God in peace and harmony. Thank you very much.
Thank you.